And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Nibbling on sponge cake, watching the sun bake, all of those tourists covered with oil, strumming my six string on my front porch swing, smell those shrimp they're beginning to boil, wasting away. Nothing to show but this brand new tattoo, but it's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. How it got here I haven't a clue, wasting away again in margarita bed, searching for my lost shaker of salt.
Man, what a lunch.
Ooh. Some people say that I got a log in the chamber.
And I know.
Gonna take a shit when I get back home.
Nailed it.
Yeah, man, I am feeling it.
Everyone's hurting. Everyone's hurting in some way that you're not.
I feel fantastic.
You should have.
I know.
I worked out. I did a sauna. I took
I'm
a cold
sweating.
Shower.
Jay's on the cusp of having to poop at work.
Whoa.
I just pooped at work.
I'm not going to poop at work.
I went and bought wipes. Had a little time.
Mm. How many did you use?
Two.
Damn. When you brought that out, I was like, I hope Dan doesn't use a lot if I do need them, because
you're going to need the rest of the pack?
Yeah, buddy, I go.
I saw Bob, by the way. Bobby,
I go.
Bobby pulled the coolest move anyone's ever pulled outside of Sirius. Where Jay and I and Christine were hanging out smoking.
This was an impossibility for 2 years ago, Bobby.
Yeah. And then I just hear, hey, guys. And I think it's the crazy guy who sells pictures of the Empire State Building.
Yeah, he's gone vocal finally.
Yeah. Oh, he's not more. Yeah. And then I look across the street and Bobby's waving. Mm. And I'm like, and then a giant truck comes by. And then when it's gone, Bobby's gone. Mm.
Which was so.
It was cool.
Cool.
I was
watching you guys through tinted windows. It was. And your shock and horror.
I was like, where did he go?
We were like, ah. Yeah. I was like, ha ha. Okay.
The best part was while you were squatting down looking, which had to look hilarious. What I thought was weird is that, talk about New York helping you out with that trick.
Yeah.
Seven people walk by you, and the reason we thought you might not be back there is because no one even looked at the man squatting, the bald man squatting behind the car. They just kept going.
Yeah, the man in the banana shoes.
One person would have just looked down, I'd be like, oh, he's definitely behind the car.
I'm wearing a teddy bear jacket with yellow sneakers, canary yellow sneakers.
So they were like, oh, this guy, this
like,
is...
That's New York.
Per usual.
New York.
New York City. There's radios. And they then probably right after went, Radio City. Because it was right there.
I felt like a chubby Houdini.
You did it. You did it. You made yourself disappear and it freaked us out.
Yeah.
I had a great, and we were all the way this weekend. Yeah. You were in Vancouver.
Yeah. Great time at JFL. Great time with Ari in Seattle, opening for Ari at the Moore Theater, where Pearl Jam lived and played. Also,
we like, know.
Okay, Jacob. Jacob, it's a really historical, cool theater. And then Vancouver.
Okay.
Vancouver was the shit. That had a lot of fun. JFL.
Yeah. I love Vancouver.
JFL Vancouver was I'm not gonna lie. I think it might be my favorite because it's just
wow. I guess Skankfest can shove it up with their ass.
Okay, out of the Jesus. JFLs, wow. You baby. I
mean, not what you were is... saying though.
No, I was saying out of the JFLs.
It's uncomfortable. Not,
you said it's my favorite of all. Of them.
All time.
No, I didn't. I didn't say of all of them. I was.
You said
say
out of
all
any
them.
Festival ever.
That's not at all what I said. You liar.
It
was
what
the,
I heard.
But it was the way you.
Bobby, keep
it.
Coming at me, and I'm gonna expose to the fans how you're in bed with the Chinese. So.
Ming hao hao.
No, that's not. No, speak
oh,
the real.
Not much, dude. Ming hao hao to you too.
No, that's not what it is.
It
you
is
know
that.
It. No, yeah. That's not.
Ding dong long. Ding dong long.
I got it right here. You
just know. Just know that.
You want it?
Just know that Bobby's an agent of chaos from the Chinese
ding
government.
Ding dong long.
Look, instead of zhen,
no up.
We only read the first down part of the third tone.
Bobby's learning it. Bobby's learning.
So it's
is it Mandarin?
Zhang ma
le
le zhang ma le
zhang ma le. Are you learning? Is that what is that? Mandarin?
It's Chinese because it's happening, baby. They're coming for us. Their balloons are here. They got the coronies here.
So you're trying to learn how to say, whose dick do I got to suck to not get killed?
Dude, don't kill me. How do I say that? Dude.
How funny if they did take over and they wound up using guys like us to work massage parlors?
Yeah. Yes.
Where we have to rub down the men. You don't even get the women.
Ooh, I almost blasted one out this weekend to a video that was. Just a massage parlor handjob video, and it was real because the girl couldn't have had more of just like the look away, like machine mechanics of it.
Yeah,
it's like this is part of the massage, like the two hand for a little bit. They roll it, they do
the Miyagi,
and then the guy comes and they kind of like jack it, and it's like it's emotionless.
What
I
got?
Like that better. I had a girl actually get into it once, and she was like, "Oh," and it freaked me out.
Did you feel like she was faking
it's
it?
Because she's faking it. That's why you get
I don't
10
know.
Cents that.
She Did seemed like she was into me.
Because she might have been into it. Bobby used to be really hot.
I think she was into me.
Because think about this woman. She's tugging off all these just animals out of Port Authority. She gets Bobby, and he's like, did you have the D'Angelo V?
She actually whispered into my pee hole something, but I don't know what it was. She like went up to my pee hole and went,
you have to travel to the top of the highest temple in China.
Bobby's the chosen one.
She went, oh, yeah, do you, Dad?
Yeah.
Did that make you come?
He goes,
take
the spirit of the dragon.
She goes, you better get out of here fast. You're running out of time. I whispered a curse into your penis. Bobby goes, what do you mean? What do you mean, dude? She goes, have you ever seen thinner? It's the opposite.
She goes, our past does not dictate our future.
Hot now, fat later. Find the boy, solve the puzzle.
Bobby's like,
what are you fucking doing? What the fuck you mean? What are you doing? You cursing me?
Is this that dragon?
Find the boy. Get skinny again.
This is the last dragon.
Bobby's
dude.
Last dragon.
You got the glow.
You got the glow.
Can you teach me some moves, dude?
Dude, it's a belt buckle, dude. All this shit for a fucking belt buckle, dude.
I'll tell you what.
You were insane.
What really hurt was one time me, Keith, and Kevin Hart went into a massage place, and three pretty girls came out, and one grabbed me first. Like, she called me to pull me back into her shower massage room.
Mm-hmm.
And but when she said it, she goes, no, I take you, big guy, back. I go, black guy's too big.
Oh,
I'm like, all right.
Oh my God, the candor.
They did that with Patrice when my first road gig was in Philly at the Dave and Buster's with Patrice and Vinny Favorito.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to the first massage parlor I've ever been to on South Street, and they wouldn't let us in. They're like, closed. And they're like, what? It's supposed to be open until like 3 a.m. And we're like, what? And she's like, no, close. And we look back, and Patrice was behind us just looking up.
Yeah.
And we were like, dude, can you step outside? And he was like, motherfucking racist. And he left. And as soon as he left, they opened the door.
Sure.
Come on.
Quick.
Because they didn't have enough girls.
Shadow, return quickly.
And you go, what? Is that what you guys say? You guys say it all Eastern and shit? Is your racist all Eastern and shit?
I don't know if he was black. I think it's because he was big. They didn't have a girl.
Yeah, you don't want the workload. You don't want a tougher workload. These women want to pop your little pink penises and then go have some tea.
I know me and Keith.
They don't want to fucking get Tommy John after a week from jacking off black guys.
They don't have to put on their wrist guards.
Yeah. Just fucking me pumping and Keith. It, pumping it like Sarah Connor in T2 when she's got the one arm.
Me and Keith both have stories of Kev out dicking us in a room where we're just like, stop, dude. Kev's always like, hey, why don't you pull their dicks out? And we're like, you're saying that because you have a 10-inch dick, dude.
That'd be like if
stop leading with that. The rest of us need to go bring in some pizzazz and funny first.
Yeah, that's so fucking funny. Hey, we should just all pull our dick out.
I'm not exaggerating, because when he would, they'd be like, shut up.
Yeah.
It's half of you.
Like touching, they would touch it like a dinosaur in Jurassic Park, where she goes up and just feels it
buddy,
breathing.
When I remember sitting in a hotel room.
She puts her head against it, her head against it, and feels it breathe.
Dude, sitting in a hotel room, entertaining two fat, black ladies watching The Matrix 1 on HBO right when it came out, while Kev is just splitting a lady in half in the other way. You just hear, like, she's like, oh, and her friend, and I'd have to be like, once in a while, I'd be like, so we're having a good time, huh?
Wow, take it easy on her, Kev. Anyway, the Wachowski brothers read this.
I go, does this make you think ever?
I know, but this is back
ever,
then.
Does this ever make you think of that maybe we're like in a simulation or something? Oh, it's so much.
Oh, you're fucking me too good.
Just half for a little bit. Half for a little.
Oh, you're turning me into a shish kebab. And you're walking, you go, you know, I've actually often heard.
What just fell out? I need that.
Deja vus are a glitch in the Matrix. Damn, that's crazy. And then how did it end? Did he come out and just...
She died. Yeah,
she walked
She's
out.
Dead. She's dead.
Her black girl hair was all frizzled out. She had to put a silk wrap on her head and leave.
Where the girl's like, thanks, Jason. Thanks for the watch along.
I think one of them came in the bathroom. It was like we were playing Truth or Dare.
They called him Jason.
And I think one of them went in the bathroom with me, and I think like I played with her boob, and she grabbed my dick and definitely made like a discernible like, ah.
You guys did special needs hooking up?
I just could. I was so worried about being hard that I just couldn't get hard before I pulled it out in the dark.
Yeah.
And still, when she grabbed it, I was just like, there's so much hand around this thing.
Did she grip it like a pulsing thing or like tug it?
Like a little of both, but it was like whatever it was, you know, the trick of that stuff is you're like, I dare you to do that for 30 seconds. And then the idea is like, they're not coming out of there.
She gets impressed.
And then, I mean, at 29 seconds, we were back out.
It's like three.
She's like,
two.
Did it. And I'm like, she did.
I've never seen it, Kevin's shtick.
Yeah.
Is it really impressive? I've seen charades.
Man,
I had to tell him, hey, man, I'm going to look at your cock for a little bit.
Yeah.
Because I've never seen anything like this.
What, you needed time with it, like a crime scene?
I needed to look at it because it was like...
Can you give me the room?
It was like seeing Elvis's leather jacket that he wore in the 68 comeback special. Like,
look at this thing.
Yeah, like, you know, you're just like, wow, is that the one he really... He was smaller than I thought.
Sweet moment.
I agree.
This was the exact
opposite. I agree with Kev. Me and Kev drove like months into comedy, maybe a year. We drove up to do a gig, like a black show in like Niagara Falls area.
Yeah.
Or maybe Toronto side, but we were at like Niagara Falls, like a hotel.
Yeah, yeah.
And we called girls to come over at like a magazine or, you know, newspaper or whatever. And I was saying no at first, and not because I'm above it at all. I was saying no because I'm like, dude, every time there's a story of me and Kev involved like with chick shit, I lose somehow. Even though we're both in for the same, you know what I mean? Like, hey, there's these two girls, or there's this girl. It's always like I end up like jumping on the grenade.
Yeah.
And Kev has a phenomenal time. And he goes, they're twin sisters. And I was like, I'm like, all right, fine.
Here's my question. Was he like on the phone with him, putting the receiver under his jaw, going,
yeah.
or his hand over it? He goes, they're sisters.
Yeah.
They're twin sisters.
Yeah.
It gets even better. I think my penis can fit through both of them.
Yeah, but not twins physically. They were just one was born before the other one.
They're not wrong.
They're fraternal.
Yeah, there's only
one of them's a dude.
Yeah, one of them's 4'2" and has a hand missing.
He goes, you know the movie Twins? It's a lot more like that.
Yeah,
it's not that double mint. More DeVito and Schwarzenegger.
I make the wrong decision on these things a lot because I have one with Metzger like this too. But he goes, I don't know if it was twins but sisters. He's like, they're sisters, so they're coming. So they're both hot, and I'm like, okay. So they come over, and actually, let me tell you the Kurt one first because it plays out in my decision making here. With Kurt, we called a girl's over one night, and she goes, I'm bringing my friend who doesn't really do this.
Wait, can I ask you a question? Mm-hmm. Were these newspaper ladies?
Yes. Yeah, this is back in newspaper times.
This is classified.
Yeah, they go, my friend will come, but she's, you know, just be cool though because she doesn't do this all the time, like I do. But she's like, no, she's my roommate.
And she's a weekend warrior.
We're like, all right. And she came over. She was wearing a good body, like slim chick. She had a like a white tank top on, like very like wiggery, like had like sweatpants mm-hmm. on and ripping Newports. And
she
other
came
girl,
over and the Save the Last Dance.
Yeah, yeah. The other girl came. The other girl came over in like the dress, like the party dress, and like looked the part, but looked like better. And I was like, well, I'm gonna go with the pros. The other girl, like, it might be weird because she doesn't know what she's doing and she's gonna be nervous and freaked out by it. And I'm like, I'll let Kurt deal with that. Dude, this girl, every time she did anything, she was like, will you come like this? All right, will you come like this? Are you going to come now? Or can you come? And I was, that was horrible. And then I look over at Kurt. I'm like, I'm almost going to be like, hey, should we ask these girls to leave? I look over, and Kurt and this girl are like, they're making sweet, sweet love.
Can I tell you?
And I was like, God damn it, man.
What happened is you made the right decision, but it was just too far the right decision because she gave you like medicinal hookering. And yeah, then the other lady was just love of the game.
So
just love a penis. And she got Kurt, who is like, she got Forrest
Gump dick. Yeah.
She got Forrest Gump dick that night.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Serves her right.
So, he's got a big one too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kurt's going to wallop.
He's our only representative in the penis Olympics, comedic penis Olympics.
Right. Come on, Dan, say that. Dan's got a big, fat, huge cock.
No, I don't.
Yeah, Jay, you do got a big dick.
No, I don't.
Dude,
that's what I heard.
Oh, yeah, from Jay.
Dude.
No, I heard that on Twitter.
Yeah, from Jay.
I heard it on Black Jay. Twitter, which is even crazy.
That is impossible.
I swear to God.
My God, dude.
Bobby.
Nothing.
I mean, it's like that thick for sure.
Not even kind of.
Right.
And that's uncomfortable.
Like, it's like a real, it's like a rolling pin.
Didn't they have to fix the vein in it because it was taking too much blood away from the rest of your body?
You guys are perfect for each other. I hope you talk about each other's penises.
And
I can go live on a ranch with my normal sized penis.
Unlike you, as the show moves forward, me and Bobby will show each other our penises.
Oh, you wanted me to show.
We're not all bashful
this
like
is,
you.
This is, you've been trying to get me to show my penis
years.
For 8 years. 8 years.
I will show two you my penis.
Two presidential terms.
This guy won't show it.
No. I will show it.
Show your dick.
He's got a big fat. All right, Christine, settle down.
It's okay.
I have a normal penis.
So with Kev, these sisters come over, and I remember it was just such a funny thing because there's a door knock, and Kev goes to the door, and I say to him, I'm like, Kev, like, look through the peephole first. Like, don't answer just yet. Like, he goes, make sure they're both, like good looking. And I mean, he walks up to the door, and he goes, he peeks through, and he goes, thumbs up, and just opens the door. And they come in, and it's like, and one is looks kind of ridiculous, but she's wearing like a prom dress. It's like so overdone. And her sister comes in wearing like jeans and a t-shirt, and like, you know, they're both like cute, but the jeans t-shirt one's cuter in like a more basic way. The other one looks so ridiculous done up. So they were like, well, how are we gonna figure out who goes with who or whatever? And the prom dress girl, the pro, the very pro looking one, goes, she goes, well, I like black dudes, so I'm gonna go with him. So we're like, nice.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm gonna get the fun girl in jeans, whatever. That girl takes off her prom dress, crazy body. Oof. Every time I'm like, this girl comes over and she goes, yeah, I do everything condoms. And I'm like, okay. I was like, but like my dick's gotta get like hard first. And she's like, fine. And what she did was she put,
was it my wife?
She put the condom over my dickhead like an Ottobisi hat. Remember Ottobisi from Oz?
Yeah. She just put a little fucking...
Like a merchant marine?
Yeah, she just had it sitting on it, and it wasn't rolling down at all. And then she would just like frog lick the reservoir tip. And as my dick would get slowly hard, you'd see she'd lick it for like a minute or two and then go... Like one swipe down on the condom. Goes, I look over at Kevin, I swear to you, this girl's elbows and wrists are moving while she's, and so much spit, and she's like, she's chugging Kev's enormous cock.
And your girl's just slowly making her way.
Dude, she's slowly licking it down, right? And then Kev, this girl, he's fucking her, and she's making like all this noise. So they finish fucking. And actually, at one point when she's fucking her, she yells, she goes, with like the from behind, like, I catch eyes with her, and she goes, I love fucking black guys. And I was like, okay.
I think the only time I've ever yelled anything similar to that was when on a roller coaster at 8 years old, and I'm like, I love roller coasters!
I thought you say, I love fucking black guys!
I've done it with tater tots.
Yeah.
I love tater tots!
She goes, I love fucking black guys.
And anytime anything's good from now on, we should all have to yell, I love fucking black guys.
And then I just remember this girl, she's looking at it, starting to get hard. And then Kev finishes with that girl.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh shit, we haven't even started like fucking yet, me and this girl.
She's just rolled down a little bit.
It's just gotten rolled down to maybe a get inside of you length.
Was she making the Yoshi noise? Was she going...
So at one point, I'm sitting there trying to focus on, like, get my dick hard if we should fuck. I just remember looking over at Kev. The other girl's in the bathroom, I assume, like Rambo stitching her pussy back together.
She's opening a knife that has stuff in it. Is it a twine? You're a son of a bitch. I love fucking black guys, she but goes I don't out, love like,
I don't want any trouble.
Yeah. I just want a sandwich.
So she's in the bed, and I remember just like this girl look, and I go, okay, right, we should like start fucking if we're going to fuck. And she goes, all right. And then she just gets on. She takes her jeans off like one leg.
Oh, my God.
Shirt still on and like gets on top of me.
Shirt
sort of.
On?
Yeah. Gets on top of me. And she's like riding me. And I'm like, I don't think it's going to happen. I don't know. I didn't say it to her, but I'm thinking about that. And I just remember just looking over at Kev. And Kev's alone in the other bed looking at me, dude. And his dick is, it's making two curves on his stomach. It goes, it's a left circle, and then it like serpentines around. Impossible. And he's just laying there looking at me like being funny. And I'm like, yo, dude. And then I was like, she goes, what, it don't feel good? She goes, or no, I look down and I go, what's that? And then she just pops up and she goes, shit, I got my period.
Oh!
And
she
goes in the bathroom and cleans up, and they're like, sorry, guys. And I'm like, how do we get sisters? He was so like, oh, this one's going to be different. And it was not different.
She didn't even get a period. She just didn't want to fuck Jay. She cut her pussy before, like a
yeah.
wrestler.
Yeah, she bladed. When Jay looked over at Kevin, she went, got it.
She goes, oops, look who's got their period.
Oh, no. Oh, I'm cut, brother. Oh, I'm having my period real bad, brother.
It was that murky blood, too, on the condom.
How did they leave? Did they leave and Kevin was like, it's like when you eat a meal.
They left.
And
then the girl literally wrote down her actual number and said, let's never do this for money again if you're ever in town.
He made her not a hooker.
Yeah.
That's
he fucked her straight.
He turned her home into a housewife and he didn't even want to.
Wow.
She's like, can I be your housewife?
And he's like, bam, here's the thing. I'm going to need babes.
Okay, boom, now. You're going to have to get in. Now, there's going to be a couple black girls going to be pretty pissed off. But now, bam, boom, bam,
Jacob, dude,
bam.
Kevin Hart.
Hey, man. Jay, that was awesome, man, wasn't it?
The only part of that story I don't believe is that he looked through the peephole.
Yeah.
Yeah, was it a handicap room?
He had to jump.
Yeah. Yeah. How did he get up to that?
Jay, I'll look through the peephole. You're going to have to give me some help.
Yeah, you're going to have to put a bookshelf over
I
here.
I can't believe he reformed a lady with his cock.
He turned it all around. And she was, when she got out of her clothes,
she tells everyone
so
she
much more like attractive than this. I thought the sister was better, and then she just had like baggy body.
Oh, man.
I bet she tells everyone. That's I fucked him for money.
That's Denzel.
I wonder if she knows. I wonder if she, like, remember, you know what I mean? It's such like a blip on the radar.
She's a school teacher now in D.C.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's one of her finest moments, fucking Kevin Hart.
She actually she's the wife of a preacher and runs a Sunday school.
They go, she talks to ex-prostitutes. He goes, it wasn't all bad. You know, I got to fuck Kevin Hart once.
Yeah. Well, I actually found my salvation being a prostitute.
Oh, I didn't even talk about how he got it going. It was the same thing almost with that Truth and Dare game, because the girl was like, she was like, I like fucking black guys and grab it. And she goes, so what do you want to do? And he goes, I like getting my dick sucked and hitting that shit from behind. And he just pulled his like pants down and it's just like soft, like knocking between his thighs. And then I was like, what do you? And the girl was like, what do you like? And I was like, I guess just sucking her a little something for a little bit.
Dude, I love that he.
I don't know, just like sucking.
I love that he pulled out a fucking loaf of bread,
dude.
And then you're just like, I like soft kissing.
Well, with the three girls, with the one he hooked up in the bathroom when I entertained her friends, that was the thing. We were playing like Truth or Dare with these girls, and he goes, Jay, dare me to pull my dick out. And I was like, Kev, okay, Truth or Dare. He's like, Dare. And I was like, I dare you to pull your dick out. And he goes, boom. He pulled it out, and they're like, dang. And they're all like talking about it. And he goes, all right, Jay. I dare you to pull your dick out now.
No.
He's like, come on, man. And then he pulled me aside. He's like, dude, they don't care, man. They want to see it. I go, Kev, I'm 2 feet taller than you, and it's going to look even worse. I wouldn't be psyched to do this if you weren't here. And now it's like, dude, you give them a comparison.
Oh, God.
He gave you a dick pep talk.
Dude, the thought that he wasn't like a real good friend would have been like, after he did that, he goes, Jay, And you go, dare. He goes, I dare you to be yourself and very charming right now. And you go, thank you,
Kev. I wish you could remember the Keith and Kev one had something where the girl was like, I forget, it was like they either chose Kev or chose Keith, because like that's the worst. I had that one definitely, is where they chose me because Kev's dick was too big. I'm not gonna do that. Looks like it's gonna hurt.
What was his pep talk? Was like, dude, there's all kinds of different dicks.
Like sort
people,
of
like tiny ones, big ones.
People like different dicks. You don't want just a big dick. When you go to a buffet, do you want all one thing? You want all kinds of little different things.
Now sure, everyone wants this one.
Yeah. Sure.
But
everyone loves prime rib. Did you? But sometimes it's vegetarians.
I like the little sausages at breakfast, the big ones for dinner.
Did you pull your dick out?
No.
Why?
I went in the bathroom with the girl, and that's when she did the little grab it at it thing. And then I just entertained them. We just watched The Matrix while Kev, loud fucked the girl. Her hat was on the wrong way when she came out. Like, he just blasted her apart.
Is she walking around like Dudley Moore and Arthur?
We
were also doing black colleges, too. That was a thing. Like, Kev sent his tape. That's why we might have been months in comedy with these things. Because Kev just right away got a tape of him doing 15 minutes and just sent it to the world. And he had, I think Bass Schuller even was like the person, or some other company that was sending him out in black colleges or something right away, right out of right out of the gates. And he was just like, I'll figure it out. And he would. And then we'd bring chicks back to the hotel. We'd bring black chicks back to the hotel.
His headshot had his cock on the other side.
Yeah, flip it around.
How much the girl had never seen a white dick that I went in that bathroom with. I don't know how to describe it other than she was a big girl. Uh-huh. And she had all of her hair was cornrowed, but into five cornrows.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like two, two on each side and one in the middle. It was really thick.
Queen Latifah.
Thick cornrow.
Queen Latifah and set it off.
Yes. Big lesbian energy.
Yeah.
And then Kareem always had the best. Like, Kareem knows how to hook up a situation with a white friend. Kareem is the shit.
Yeah.
I love that Kareem on talk. Oh, man, he was so good. We hooked up with a girl by my mom's house once forever ago. Black girl. We just met her at a bar. She wasn't even at a show. And she came back to the room. It was so funny. I remember there was two beds in the hotel room.
Yeah.
We were close enough to my mom's that I was like, hey, if this chick's not down the fuck. It's so funny because now I would be like, if my friend pulled a girl, I'd be like, you go with them or whatever. But I would never even think like, hey, can we both fuck her? But at the time I was like, sure, we could both fuck her.
Yeah.
It's so funny how, I don't know how that just fell out of my repertoire, but now I'd be like, nah, I'm good.
Yeah.
But at the time I was like, nice, this might work out. And I just remember them two were laying on one bed and I'm kind of laying on the other bed. Just everyone's fully clothed, just sitting around, maybe smoking pot. I don't even think so. Might've been before that. But I remember you just hear Kareem go like in her ear, and she goes, oh, I knew that was coming. And then he's like, well, I mean, and she goes, yeah, I don't know. And he goes, and she goes, well, just don't none of y'all put it in my ass. And I just remember getting up and walking over, and we hooked up with that chick.
Did you do a little tip of a fake hat? Hello, m'lady.
Like in The Sting?
Yeah.
Hello. Well, that's the one I scared away from with Dave Smith. Dude, my road pussy stories are always so funny, dude. The Dave Smith, when I talked to the girl, I summoned Patrice on this one.
I thought you meant like with a Ouija board.
No, I summoned Patrice. No, it was like, I think Patrice was still alive actually when this happened.
Jesus.
So but he just like, had a professor, he had a Professor X moment.
No,
where he was just wearing one of his hats and he went, Jay's getting into some filthy shit.
Well, no, I mean summoned them like just like, the idea of like his like watching him operate and stuff. And it was, again, not a girl from the thing. She just came back.
Where'd you meet her?
From the Dave and Buster's near Pittsburgh.
Okay.
Near the Pittsburgh Comedy Club or whatever.
Yeah.
And she came back to the room after the show and just talking
to
her.
Was she just at Dave and Buster's looking for dick?
No, she was a waitress. She was our waitress.
Oh.
Patrice would break them down, though. He would talk to them and break them down.
No, that's what I did.
And he would do it like he's doing you a favor. Like,
yes.
This ain't about me. This is about you having an orgasm. I want to make you happy. You don't get to come. And your guys don't take time with you, and you deserve to come. And I want to help
you. I'm telling
you,
whatever I did, I talked this girl. I've never been more proud of myself. I've never done anything like it again.
Yeah.
In this night, this girl came over, like, literally, I'm just coming to smoke weed. She even goes, if I'm coming to your room, like, don't think.
Yeah, don't think nothing of it.
Yeah. She goes, but I'll take your weed and smoke some weed and hang out with you guys.
Right.
And at one point, she was just, from my words, Dave Smith will tell you, it was pageantry. She was. she was naked smoking weed with us. And then basically saying she wanted to like
her,
fuck around.
The thought of her going fully clothed and just topless to the completely naked.
Yeah, it was crazy.
Still smoking the same joint.
Like a time lapse?
Yeah.
And then talking, this is the funniest though. That's when she, I've told you this before, for sure, Dan. But I even suggested, I was like, it was a balcony.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, I'm going to go smoke a cigarette. You kids go get started on the bed or some kind of thing, you know? And like her and Dave go over and they're making out on the bed. And I think she was like sucking his dick, but she was, if you could picture, laying on her back,
mm-hmm.
like with the direction of the bed, mm-hmm. the way you would lay on your back, feet planted on the bed, so her knees are bent, but like bent but closed,
mm-hmm.
and she's got her head to the side, blowing Dave.
Is he laying?
No, he's standing. Okay. He's standing beside the bed. And I'm smoking a cigarette, and I'm like, all right, he goes, let's, here we go, time to jump. I threw the cigarette, and I come in, dude, and I remember this poor girl. This poor girl, what this must have looked like to her. Just her legs were closed, and I like shark finned her leg. And she opened her legs. It wasn't like I was fighting. She wasn't like, but I just went, I opened her leg, and she just saw my dumb fat face go like, I said, mind if I join the party? And
she went, Jesus Christ.
She goes, I'm actually uncomfortable. And I went, no, yeah. And I left in my socks. And it was snowing outside, and I couldn't go outside. I went in like the business. The business center and
you just
played
checked
on,
your email?
Played on like early you internet.
Did a, you did a sitcom pussy entrance?
No.
Mind if I join
the party?
Like Larry from Three's Company?
Oh, how's the water?
What the fuck?
Is the water
it was
warm?
So bad.
Hey, what are you two doing in here?
Dave Smith told me that was like her thing though. I left and then I was like, well, I'll leave him up. And about 15 minutes later, Dave's like, come back up, dude. Like, come back up.
No, that's scary.
And when she left shortly after, like, fine. You know, we smoked more weed and she left. And I kind of made a joke about running out of there. And then Dave was just kind of like, you know, friendly with her. And then she left and Dave was like, yeah, dude, that was weird. Like, that was like her thing the whole time. Like, she would blow him for a little bit. And then she'd be like, I don't think I should do this. I think this is bad. And he'd go, oh, yeah, all right. Well, then, like, you know, I'll walk you down if you want to leave. And she'd go, no. And then she's like sucking his dick again. And then be like, I don't know. I should probably go. Like, he said she did, like, until he didn't even finish. He said eventually he was like, I'm going to call Jay to come back up because I don't think he has shoes.
She didn't have a dad.
Maybe
that's like a single parent where the hey don't do that you don't you're full you're not you had enough. She didn't have that person. She doesn't make a decision.
Yeah,
I have the same thing. I mean, not with blowing guys.
But. Dude, all right, pull it out. I gotta get out of here.
Dude, I don't want to.
Dude, I feel like
Bobby. Mind if I join the party?
I feel uncomfortable. You're making me uncomfortable. You just came up through my legs. Where were you?
I would love to see your beautiful eyelashes flicker.
I mean, how those baby blues? How could you not be like?
No, all to me, all shows fat face go. Hey, I want to play. She's like a young, pretty girl. I mean, I was young too, I guess. Yeah. But like, it just like I felt like a big old fat weirdo.
Hey. You come through and you go. I loved him. Munch.
Yeah.
And she goes, what?
Ooh, pussy looks delicious.
Oh, is pussy on the menu?
Do I like smell mine. Cotton candy?
I like mine over easy.
How many tickets at Dave & Buster's to lick this pussy?
How many skee ball wins do I got to get? Yeah, man, those stories. I'm really like, I have so many of them. I was so awkward. With like those chicks, but yeah, the fucking there's another one with Kev too. I'm trying to remember where it went, like haywire. Kurt, we had a couple.
Well, both of those both of those guys just have enormous penises.
Well, the best.
So you know what Kurt's they're playing. You know what their fucking fastball is.
Well, Kurt's best is we were jokes on us in Maryland, which I think is the same gate I was coming home from with Kareem when that happened. Damn. It's also the same place where me and Kareem got robbed. Or you know, they tried to rob us.
There's a lot going on there.
Crazy place.
They robbed you?
Laurel, Maryland. Yeah,
what do you mean
yeah.
tried to rob you?
They pulled out a gun. I was in the car.
Oh, they pulled out a gun.
We drove away.
Really?
But the Kareem was out of the car when they first pulled the gun. I was able to get him back in the car, thank God. Because he was still going. He was acting like it wasn't a deadly situation.
Jesus Christ.
The gun never went off. So I may, oh, it may Jesus. Never have been loaded, but I'll never know. I remember, man, we went to bed that night.
Yeah.
And Kareem was just like, man, we should have killed those motherfuckers. He was snoring 2 seconds later. I was up all night. I was up all night, I just got to call somebody. Like, that was fucking crazy, man. Like that was so intense.
Yeah,
like,
looking out a window, smoking a cigarette. It's just time elapsed. And then Kareem's just switching sides. And like,
he never thought about it again. I flipped out 3 weeks later at a Red Hot Chili Peppers concert.
Really?
Yeah, I went and cried in the bathroom. I had like a panic attack. We were trying to get, Craig Gass was saying we can go to the side stage. We were walking up.
He knows Mike McCready, you know?
And there was a security guard who was like saying, you can't go this way. We got to go back. So now there's a bunch of people behind us that we have to go, like, sorry, guys, like, we got to go back. But the security guy kept putting his hand on my back and be like, come on, man, you got to move. And I'm like, yeah, man, I'm like, I'm telling them to go. I can only move as fast as they move. And he's like, well, you got to move. I was like, dude, take your hand off my back right now. And then he was like, all right, man, but you got to get out of here. And then like 10 seconds later, he put his hand on my back. And I was like, I don't want to be touched. I don't want to be touched. And I went in the bathroom. And Carla was like, what's the fuck is that about? I was like, oh, I'm just going to go in the bathroom. I went in the bathroom and like cried for like 5 minutes. And then came out. I'm like, what the fuck was that?
That was, you go, that's from a couple of weeks ago.
We got a gun back, came right out of it. But yeah, it was scary as shit. But
Anthony Kiedis is like, Zabba-dabba-dee. What's up with that guy? That guy's losing his shit.
It doesn't seem like you, dude. It does not. I can't imagine you flipping out like that.
From someone touching your back?
Yeah, leave me
alone.
I
was just like, dude, I felt, I don't know how to, I think, I mean, I never really went to therapy about anything, but I mean, how vulnerable, when that guy pulled that gun, pointed at the front windshield of the car, I was like, it was so real.
Yeah.
Because it was a very dark situation happening where, like, this could have happened.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, it was like the middle of Nowhereville, Laurel, Maryland, in the middle of the night. It was bad.
I had a guy in my apartment. With me tied up.
Yeah.
Tapping a gun on my head.
And now you're incapable of love.
Yeah. And now I can't have intimacy. So, you know, you just got to remove the layers. It's an onion.
There was a comic this weekend that shot somebody.
Well, it wasn't last weekend because we covered it on Skanks. Oh, check it out, castdigitalnetwork.com. There was a comic that hung out at the stand that shot a guy on the N train in Brooklyn.
Crazy.
And he was like a comic.
And he shot him because they had like some stare off or something, right?
Yeah. It was what the fuck are you looking at?
He was on Berg's podcast before.
No shit.
Yeah, Berg's
base. A lot of people were saying that's what it was.
They said Gas Digital set him off. They're trying to blame Ralph and Lewis.
A lot of people were saying that's what it came down to.
We went to Margaritaville for lunch.
Yeah.
We went and ate at the Jimmy Buffett staple of New York City.
Yeah.
And there was a guy there that had the opposite of Jay's shirt. Jay wears shirts like reading is gay or like gay for pay or like, you know, fun stuff. And this guy had a shirt that said, don't threaten me. What was it? It was like,
don't disrespect me.
Don't disrespect me, written in old English. Did you see that guy's shirt that was in there? Yeah, he was, don't disrespect me.
Of course
you
saw him. Him and Lou had to nod to each other to show respect. They were both in Margaritaville.
There you go. Well, you guys are.
He goes, you checking out the schedule of the change of shift?
What's on your shirt, Dan?
Grease.
From what?
One of the delicious treats we had there.
How'd you get on your shirt? What is it?
I don't. It's still fucking dirty. It's grease.
It's because you stand so straight up with your shoulders back.
No, I got it all.
I never get food on my shirt because I always hunch over my food like I'm fucking protecting it.
You
from
know
others.
What it was? I think I was eating something and I looked back at the fucking Statue of Liberty, the Planet of the Apes Statue of Liberty, and the fucking Margaritaville.
Hangburger in hang.
Grease went all over it. Tide Stick didn't work.
When I was fat, all my shirts have grease stains on my stomach because. It would fall, whatever food would fall and hit my gut.
Oh, on the way down.
The top
on
the
way
thing, down. Yeah, the top part, the slope. Top,
yeah, the slope.
Yeah, I got to fucking try to tie it stick again.
Jacob
this.
Fell in love with a waitress again. Every time we
Yeah.
Oh, good for you. Did you give her your number?
No. She didn't feel the same for me.
Oh, did you say hi?
He did not give it a go.
Yeah, but
I will say, she seemed, but sometimes it could be a good thing too. She seemed unnecessarily annoyed with just Jacob. He did nothing. Like it was the first time when he goes, hey, he goes, is it possible to put our dessert order now? She goes, yeah, I just got to like put stuff down first and I'll come back.
Yeah, and you're like, oh, all right, is there a little bit of a little will they, won't they, huh?
But Bobby, you're a ladies' man.
Yeah.
What do you think? Was that good or bad? That was
well, my wife, I don't know if you know this, I met her at a restaurant. We were both waiting tables at the same time.
Is that right?
And she was a bit of a kind of twatty once in a while, you know? So it might be actually... you know, what do you got, dude? What's going on? You could have, at that moment, said, hey, sorry about that. I know you're busy and a little. And then thrown her, you know, like a nice 10 spot. Be like, this is for you.
I tipped her well.
How much you tip her?
25%. More than that. More than that.
It's got to be, dude. You got to throw 30. Down.
You should have done it in cash.
35.
Oh,
put
it
in cash. And you should have stuffed it in the back pocket of her fucking khakis.
And then gone, there's 35. A lot more where that came from.
Well, if you grabbed the front of her shirt and pulled it open and let it fall down towards her nipple.
Oops, was that a mistake?
Yeah.
When they immediately don't like me for, and I have no idea what I even did.
Yeah.
I mean, that hits you in the gut.
Yeah, it does.
Look, I didn't. Jay picked up on it, like he said. I don't know what I did.
She did not. She was mean to you.
It was her first. It was her first aggressive thing of the day.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, every time they came over, they did give us a thing. Like we were told like that they were hooking us up there because Hard Rock Johnny was.
Shout out to Hard Rock Johnny.
He was like, "Oh man, we'll take care of you." I let him know and everything. But when they let they should tell like when you let somebody know that you know we're going to take care of them and
that
whatever.
They're a special table.
But don't just tell them, like, and maybe say like also like and be nice. Like I feel like you just told them like there goes, hey, these guys are getting like a big discount, whatever like that. So we were treated like we won an award, like we won a prize of a free thing, and they're like they're not going to tip us at all. Like it was they acted like, we were already not going to tip.
She assumed we weren't going to tip.
By the way, I get
tip
that.
At the beginning. What? I'll drop a 20. I'll be like, listen, here, this is for you. We're tipping you too. This is for you too. Take that, and then they. Switches the whole thing.
That is a good. That's
switches
a fucking.
Switches the whole thing.
By the way, Bobby, if I was a waiter and you would have handed me a 20, I would have been on your
right
table
out of, right
like
out
a
of the gate,
motherfucker.
This is for you. We're tipping you to whatever the percentage is, but this is for you out of the gate. You're busy today. Thank you so much.
I would have treated my newer tables like shit compared to you.
100%.
If I would have got that 20, I'd be like, oh, you guys need some fucking coach.
Just drop a crap in their fucking quesadilla.
Yeah, just be like, sir, anything. More guacamole? I can get you another guacamole.
When I go to a hotel, I tip 20 at the front. As soon as I walk in,
ooh,
I go,
check-in guy?
I go, hey, this is for you. Yeah. 20 bucks.
So the guy checking you in.
Checking me in. I give him a double berry. Where does that go? Better room, higher floor. Anything goes wrong, it gets taken care of.
So when you go to pull out your license and credit card, you just drop a 20.
Hey, what's up, man? I go, I cuff it.
Okay.
How you doing? What's going on?
Dude, I love fucking.
This is for you. Thank you so much for letting me check in. I don't even say that. I go, thanks for checking to see if I can check in early.
I love high roller
Bobby.
That's
good. Yeah. I give obnoxious tip at comedy clubs in my green room. I make them, especially if it's like a black female, always because I'm like, yeah, remember this when you're with Bruce next week or whatever?
Yeah.
Like, remember that? I bet he's not going to lay this on you.
I give 20 a night, and then if it's a good weekend, everybody gets a double berry.
Not me. I give. You want to know what I give? I'll tell you.
What's a double berry?
It's going to make everybody feel
20.
Two 20s.
Two 20. Oh. No, 120.
Huh?
Oh,
20.
So a berry is a 10?
A double berry on the wheel on the slot machines. It's a two berries.
Oh,
yeah, two tens.
Oh.
10 is a solid.
Oh. I don't tip the staff at comedy clubs. I give them advice about the business.
That's good.
I say protect your IP. I say get ready to
maybe I'm going over
own
the top.
What you make.
I do on the one day show, 50.
Yeah, oh, geez.
On the two day show's Hundo. Night.
Whoa!
No. That's too much. You're fucking the rest of us.
Yeah, what are you doing, dude?
You're fucking the rest of us, Jay.
That's crazy. God
damn it.
Jay,
that's why they hate us. God. You're killing us.
Is that why they don't like you guys?
Yeah, dude.
Man.
You're fucking us.
All right, Salt
Lake
City.
Because I have an army of pretty ghetto black chicks right now in St. Louis that will fuck your night up if you want them to.
God damn, Salt Lake. I guess I'll get 250 out of the fucking bank.
Yep, 20 bucks.
Wait, you do 50?
50 Thursday.
And then one and one?
And then one-on-one.
That's $250. It's too much.
All right, Jay.
It's too much. What about,
I'll see your fucking price. Salt Lake City, Utah.
And then I go,
this Thursday through Saturday.
Who you calling a bitch?
When I go like this. This is called the J-Tip.
That's for unity. I play this on a loudspeaker. What's up, girls? You ain't a bitch or a hoe.
I love you come in with the dashiki on. You go, my queens.
Also, when you give a nice tip to the black waitstaff, they will talk the shit about the black comics who coming in. They'll let you know who sucks.
Really?
Oh, they can't wait to tell you.
I mean, all comedy club staffs will do that. All you need is just a couple questions, and they're like, you want to know who really fucking melted down here? And you're like, go ahead.
Go ahead
and tell me.
I usually like a lot of the comedy club staffs, but I never get the group. Like, I always see, like, after me or before me, there's some horny Adam surrounded by every waiter and waitress taking
And they all have a theme.
And I never asked to take a photo with the
they ask
staff.
You for the staff photo though they don't ask you to do it
never and I'm never on the wall
here's the test
are you on the wall
here's
anywhere?
The test I'm on
never
I'm on the wall permanent in one place only
Nashville
in the whole country no I wish I was one of those paintings they're not bad the no I'm Rosemont Zanies the one by the airport is like a forever decal of me on their outside wall
that's cool.
I'm on Comics Roadhouse they have the sticker
They
used to promote. I've been playing there since they opened. They finally put it on last time.
Jesus.
But they did it at least.
Yeah.
But I don't.
No, Bobby, I'd say we'd be fantastic ahead of the game if in by the middle of our contract that's coming up here if there's any sort of a picture of us up on that screen out there. They are not
wild.
A rush. I think they still have a full panel Nikki Glaser.
It's probably going to take them. They'll never take you down.
No.
You'll still be up there.
Trust me, from what Jim told us, I'll be out of there Thursday. I'll be off that screen.
They're packing Dan's thing upstairs.
I'm going to disappear like a McFly picture.
Everything they've ever found. Like, there's this one sock, but I think it's yours. It's in the box. Throw it at yourself.
Yeah, they're like, they found a wrestling action figure. They're just going to put it in the box. They think it's my Triple H action figure. It could be Sam Roberts's.
Someone gave me this weekend the action figure of Burr from Mandalorian.
Oh, that's awesome.
There's an action figure of him.
I didn't know that. That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's pretty wild. I just talked to Burr coming in here.
Dad.
Yeah.
Dad.
I was playing the drums with the Comedy Jam yesterday.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, he's a goddamn good drummer, man.
Yeah, I watched him like go for it too. I watched him like, I remember when he got his first electric kit and we'd go over his place and like play it. But he was like, we would go over and just like dick around.
Yeah.
And then Justin got one and then I got one. But Bill was like actually like, no, I'm like learning like the note. He's like learning like the, you know, the paradiddles and all. He was like doing it right. And I'm like, oh. I thought we were just dicking around with the radio.
Yeah, I thought we were just going to jam.
Man, he's real good.
Yeah, can he play most? Can he learn a song? Can he read music?
He did Kickstart My Heart, which is pretty hard to stay on. It's like a hard timing.
Yeah.
It's very, very fast. You know what I mean? But yeah, he's good. Yeah, Bill can play for sure.
Nonchalant, though. He's not like Tommy Lee where he's, you know, spinning and, you know, he doesn't have drummer face. He's just.
Oh, no. It's complete mechanics.
That's it, mechanics. Nonchalant, though. Very nonchalant. You know? Do-do-do-do-do. Boom.
And his face, I do all this. I go.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'd be fucking a lot of tongue out.
Yeah.
Big hands.
While I'm flipping upside down.
I did the Comedy Jam in Montreal, I was so excited.
I
wore a wig. It was so great. And then at the end, I was so happy, I threw my sticks out and hit a chick in the face.
Oh.
And she came back and she goes, here.
Oh.
She gave it back to me.
Oh. I should ask Josh if I can.
You went. Ping. Yeah.
The only thing I'm built to do is play bass. I should ask if I could play bass in the Comedy Jam.
I'm pretty sure I heard ow.
Oh.
Ow. You'd be a good bass player.
That's my movement.
Oh, something's attached to my ankle and I don't know what it is.
It's your foot, silly goose.
I think it's a mouse.
Really? Just hiding in your pants.
You just want to hold the bass and look like you're playing.
Yeah, I don't even have to play it. Let me air bass. Whole thing.
You can learn the bass in 3 days, dude.
And you guys, in my hotel room at the festival, you walk up and just hear me plucking.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, guys. I just learned a couple new jams.
Where's
for today.
Dan? He's fleeing in his room.
I'm just in my underwear. Fucking make those big movements. With fucking red, green hair. Oh.
Hey, what's up, Jake?
The fuck, my teeth are even farther apart.
Why don't we have a band?
Let's do it, dude. I'll play
Can I tell you something? I've argued this with many comics for many years. We should, in whatever capacity we have, put together a band, not trying to be necessarily great covers, and we play people's weddings. Fans will pay us buku bucks to come be the wedding band.
Let me tell you right now, I will...
Christine, shut the fuck up.
Yeah. Can we cut out?
What the fuck, man?
That's negative shit.
You know what you are in the VH1 Behind the Music? You're the girlfriend that said it couldn't happen. So
it's so
remember, stupid. A
wedding band of comics,
and then, dude, standing ovation coming and playing your fucking wedding.
Dude. Bobby's sweating. I'm in the front. Yeah. Ah, stand alone.
And I'm standing
like,
there.
Why are they playing this? Because they only know like five songs, and three of them are Godsmack.
And I'm standing behind you with a waffle shirt under a t-shirt, just playing bass. Soder got a heroin problem from being a cover band.
Dude, we should do a band, and I think we should do covers, but we should come up with some originals.
Oh my god!
Absolutely.
Two drink minimum.
Dude, we could come up with.
Fuck Cameo. We'll write a song for your wedding when you hire us.
Yes.
Yeah. And I will fucking have a fifth of that bass line.
When Kate first saw John at a bar and she knew she was gonna fuck him that night.
She wore a yellow dress from hell and gave a hand job from heaven.
I can't wait for you guys to get a cease and assist from Josh.
Come from Paramus, New Jersey with the
Sorry, guys. This is kind of my bread and butter.
The hurricane came in, took the house away, but they're still there to say hey, hey.
Dude, I love it.
Dude, we could do all weddings. We could do bachelorette parties.
Yes.
Birthdays.
Oh, God, and the in-between songs?
Oh, my God.
And we're not going to be crazy priced.
No.
But it's if you're hiring us... You know who we are.
I got a wedding
so
coming up.
So you're going to give a couple smackers to have us be there. And by the way, don't even... we will hang up the phone. I think I speak for the group. We'll hang up the phone immediately if you ask us to do comedy in any kind of way.
No way.
Nothing to do
going
with
the Hannibal route. I like that.
Yeah.
Now, I'm just, we're just feeling this out.
Yeah.
I'm getting married soon.
Yeah.
I'm a groom to be.
Yeah.
How much? What are we talking about here? To come play? We're going to have a nice little...
Where's your wedding?
Holiday and nice little ceremony.
What town?
In Springfield, Mass.
Oh, Christ. Dude, destination. That destination?
Yeah. Well, okay. You know what? Let me change the scenario just so we can get to the pricing.
Yeah.
Long Island.
Yeah, Dan's going to be like, hey, you guys check out the tartar sauce fountain yet?
Tartar sauce is so retarded.
3,700.
It's going to be a special sauce fountain. Because now Hidden Valley makes special sauce in a squeezable tube.
Shut up.
I say 1,000 each. For your wedding, 1,000 each.
1,000 each? Well, I'm in the band, motherfucker.
What do you play?
Yeah, you get 1,000 too.
What the hell do you play?
Yeah, he's the bass, dude.
You don't know how to play the bass, dude. Somebody knows how to play the bass in comics.
No.
Yeah, Jim Tews.
Does he?
Yeah.
Ah, fuck him though.
Okay. Well,
I think it's one of the guys that was like. I think it's one of the guys. I think
Jay,
I was,
you guys are going to be doing a radio show. I'm going to have so much time to learn bass.
I think Jim Tews was like an anti-LOS guy.
Okay. Well, he's out because I'm back in because I told you.
Yeah.
From 5 to 7.
Can I?
I'll be down the street at a music studio learning the bass.
Jay, are you? Who's? Are we co-singing? Right.
Damn.
Buddy,
this is.
Not only can we co-sing.
Yeah.
How about this? Because I'll tell you what I cannot do.
Okay.
Play drums and sing at all at the same time. Impossible.
Can you play drums and sing?
I can play
probably
drums
a little
and
bit. You can
Phil Collins.
I can do a little.
No, I mean like.
I can feel it.
But I was saying, I think we can trade
bases for that.
Listen, I can sing.
Yeah.
And do random percussion.
Great.
Jump in the kit if you want to jump out in front man for a little bit.
If I could come out, I would love to for Dan's wedding.
Particularly.
I would love to a rock romance jam. You know what
Absolutely.
I mean?
We were looking, Katie and I actually were talking about having a little bit of a medley. Could you do like a medley jam?
I will do a medley of all Lionel Richie songs up to and including Endless Love.
Could you, for a price, also do some Billy Ocean? I'm not talking about Caribbean Queen.
I mean,
I'm talking
That's
lover.
What I would do.
No. I want Lover Boy. I want...
Romancing the Stone?
I want it all,
I
want to
be
dude.
Your lover, lover boy.
Yeah. I mean, I would say you're going to have to...
It's not fun to play.
It's not good.
I don't give a shit if it's fun to play.
Caribbean Queen, though, we could... Probably the one we'd
be. I guess
there's a lot of instrument in that I'll never understand. Whatever goes.
Well,
synthesizer.
Guess what? You got the date, figure it out.
We're going to need songs that are a little more straight up rock.
How about Pat Benatar?
There you go.
Yeah, you guys are out. You know what?
And I'll tell you what, I could probably get Bobby with me to learn the entire. I know the whole. We are young, tonic to heartache. We stand to dink.
Yeah, that's great and everything, but I'm going to need you guys to learn Freakazoid.
What?
I need you guys to learn the song Freakazoid, or you're not getting hired, because that's our first dance.
Is that the one that goes, because I will be a freak on to
no,
the day.
No, it's the one that goes, Z-O-I-D-S, Freakazoid, Z.
Can I say something? Black Lou is gonna renew his vows if I keep it up with him. He's over there loving this.
This is what you guys need to learn how to play.
Freakazoids, robots, please report to the dance floor.
Dude, I told you, we've been playing this and dancing at Myrtle, doing the robot, and it freaks her out, our dog. Can you guys play this?
Yeah, I can do this.
Yeah, just on a record.
Yeah, we can dance to this.
Yeah, I'll get you guys all the cardboard you need.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I can't wait to do an acoustic. You gotta feel it. It's actually a woogie woogie woogie.
Oh, wow.
I see you out there, Dan's grandma.
She's going to be probably dead by the wedding.
Oh.
I don't know. We don't know.
Jesus Christ.
If she's alive, she sure as shit ain't going to be at the wedding. It's like transporting a bowl of gelatin. You can barely get her to the store and back. She is a vase, my friend. We aren't putting on her any form of hard traveling. If we don't get married in Lake County, it ain't right.
Imagine the bowl of jello
reminded
me.
You feel if she was there, like just wondering if she's gonna
die
make
at any
it
moment?
Through the wedding. Yeah.
You go, hey, I think your cloudy-eyed grandma's talking to Reggie Conquest.
Dude, when Metzger described years ago as one of the Joe's leaving upset, the Comedy Cellar, Metzger described Joe as like he said somebody forgot to let Joe finished setting in the fridge before they took him out. It's like so Jello. Funny. It's just like loose Jello.
That's so funny.
He goes, they forgot to let Joe finish setting in the fridge.
And he was like, fuck you, dude. I'm gone.
Yeah.
Hey, did you send out your invitations yet?
No, we haven't even picked a date, right, dude. Okay. We don't have, right. We have zero idea.
I got a little nervous that you say Reggie Conquest is coming.
No, he's definitely not coming.
I thought we got zipped out of it.
I think Katie has me and you probably tier two or three.
No, you're tier one.
Are we tier one? But are we at the same, what table are we at?
It'd be a bonfire table.
But is it a one? Is it around you guys? Is it set back?
No, dog.
Colin's wedding, I was at the, you know, I was at the retard table.
Yeah, no.
Really? They put you with the doofs?
Well, probably.
Amy and Seinfeld and all those people at this big long table. And then I was at the, another table. I mean, it wasn't the Colin's cousin and the Nick DiPaolo table, which was like in the middle over to the left.
That's the disease was fake.
We had, but Norton switched tables and sat with us because he was at another table.
That's awesome.
And then he realized he fucked up.
Yeah.
Because he had more famous people at that table and he tried to switch back, but they wouldn't let him switch back.
I would imagine I have a bonfire table with all you guys together, and then I have like a Colorado table.
For Mine says with Paul Giamatti.
He's not coming to my wedding.
Is he coming? He's coming to your wedding?
No.
You guys told me we were super close.
No, he didn't.
Is he coming as Einstein?
No, I'm actually coming as Ebenezer Scrooge. He is going to be performing as one of his characters in the Verizon universe.
Oh, that's awesome.
But as Ebenezer Scrooge.
Is he marrying you?
But Axe Capital's coming. Yeah. For sure Axe Capital's coming.
Oh, yeah. I might have him show up as Chuck Rhodes.
Yeah. And then is your Alec Baldwin, I think, is coming?
Yeah. Post-prison stint. So we're going to have to push it back a little bit.
Yeah, Baldwin. Well, no, he already got dropped, like, I think, the biggest stuff.
Oh, yeah. We've done, like...
You know how
14 months in jail he might spend?
How much of the accusations against Marilyn Manson have worked for me, just like on the person level of it, is that I believe everything has been dropped. And I even think some of the girls have come out in articles and said, like, I was actually kind of coerced into saying that. Like, yeah, like, I don't know. There was like these girls were like breathing down my neck trying to get me to say this stuff, so I did it. And so he's kind of cleared, and I'm still like, yeah, but you're definitely not awesome. Like,
yeah,
you're definitely not an awesome guy. Probably
you're a big fan of his.
Huge.
Yeah,
but
he looks bad now.
Oh my God!
Terrible. I took Christine to see him twice. The last two times I went to go see him, I took Christine, and poor Christine. She knows like he was my like all time favorite live. Yeah. And I remember Christine's face. She goes, "It was good," and I was like, "No,
Christine, sucked about it? Was he just like not?
She never saw another version, so for her,
I never got to see him like in all his glory, and he really was such an incredible performer, and it just felt like he was phoning it in a bit.
Well, the one I told you, he did the thing that was at Chicago Open Air when they had him on the big screens. This is the second time me and Christine went to see him, and when he's up on the podium doing like the Antichrist Superstar song, he's got the things up that. They're shooting him like right up from the ground, just his face, and he does like he blows a snot rocket and it just stays on his lip, and then it goes off of him because the crowd goes, oh, it's like 30,000 people. They go, oh, it was a soccer stadium, and then it goes away from him, and then when it cuts back to him for, and I'm not exaggerating, 3 seconds, because then they go off again, because when they cut back to him, he's going. He's trying to blow it off his lip. It was so gross. Christine called me.
Yeah, I got booger on me again.
What gets me the gags is so out of nowhere. Christine the other day, I was on the phone with her in that loading dock in St. Louis Helium.
Yeah.
I was up back, this is where all the staff goes to hang out. I was just walking down, and I was coughing from like weed. I was, and then I looked down, and it was someone like spit on the floor, but it was the clear spit, and in the middle of it, just like, you know, the snotty loogie. Oh. Mm-hmm. And I just looked down and I was like, ugh. She's like, well, I'm home. So I'm like, I'm trying to throw up. Yeah. She kept saying that. I was like, and I couldn't get it out of my head. It was like one of those, like, I had to like change the conversation or something to not think about it. That was sticking with me.
Oh.
Even as I say it now, it doesn't hit me that same way. But man, when I saw it, I was
floating?
Like, oh, loogie.
That's disgusting.
I can't get off talking with Shane.
I don't want to talk about
Shane
it.
And Nate, when they would come over with their chaw, the dip spit. And then just like forget it. And like, by the way, it's not like someone like left a water bottle in your house. It's like grabbing the outside of
the
those.
Weight?
Grabbing the outside of those is the grossest thing. You're like, dude, it's just like you're yakking there. Like you're,
yeah. Just the weight of chaw spit.
I used to go to AA dances when I first got sober.
It's a funny thing.
I used to go to AA dances and.
Woogie, woogie, woogie.
And I used to. I was by a payphone one night trying to get more time out of my mom. She was only 16 and a half.
Yeah.
And I was like, Mom, and you could hear, like, you know, they had the B-52s, and then they were playing Stairway to Heaven was the final song at all the dances. And I was like, Ma, please, I'll be home. And I took a sip, and there was a girl where you are, and I was just looking at her, pretending I wasn't talking to my mom. And I took a sip of my coffee, I don't know, and it was someone spit in the cigarette cup. And I had three cigarettes hanging out of my mouth. And I went, blah, 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 blah. And the girl just looked at me and fucking laughed and walked away. And I go, Ma, I'll be home in a couple minutes. Oh. I just left. Yeah. Yeah, they played the Stairway to Heaven every AA dance.
Damn. First hour flew. We got to take a break. We have Sal's coming in to hang out with us.
Yeah.
Sal Vulcano from the Impractical Jokers is here. We'll be right back. No live reads. It's the bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Feel just like a rock star. All my brothers got that gas and they always be smoking like a rock star. Fucking with me, call up on the Uzi and show up, man, them the shot toss. When my homies pull up on your block, they make that thing go grata-ta-ta. Hey, hey. Switch my whip, came back in black, I'm starting saying recipes of Bonska. Though we blowing smoke, she asked me light a fire like a Mars song. Ay. Act a fool on stage, probably leave my fucking show in a cop car. Ay. Shit was legendary, through a TV out the window of the montage. Cocaine on the table, liquor pouring, don't give a damn. Dude, your girlfriend is a groupie, she just tryna get in. Saying I'm with the band. Ay. Ay. Now she acting out of pocket, tryna grab up on my pants. 100 bitches in my trailer, say they ain't got a man. And they all brought a friend. Yeah, ay. I've been fucking hoes and popping pillies, man, I feel just like a rock star. All my brothers got that gas and they always be smoking like a rock star. Fucking with me.
Hand music cues are always funny.
Is that LL Cool J?
Yeah. Post Malone.
Yeah, tell everyone it is.
Uncle L, Future of the Funk. We have Post Malone's new best friend here in studio with us, everybody. Joining us from the Impractical Jokers, currently on tour right now, it's the hilarious Sal Vulcano joining us.
Yes.
Thank you so much. You know what it is.
You know what's up.
Sorry, I've been hanging out with Post there.
Oh, yeah, dude. You have all these face tats. I'm like, Sal changed almost immediately.
Yeah.
The makeup chair for
Sal's got one face tattoo. He goes, I got talked into it.
We had Sal, a wild breakfast.
There's something with him, Post Malone.
I was just joking.
Oh,
I got the face tattoo after a wild breakfast.
I believed he had a wild breakfast with Post Malone. I wanted to show the crew this. I thought this would make you laugh pretty hard, Sal, too. So, you know, I watch Love After Lockup. It's one of my favorite shows.
Yes.
Recap it. Someone's wife at a show this weekend called me. They were like, she goes, she started to like the show. I know she was asking. She goes, what's that show where the guy talks about Love After Lockup? That's what you described the show as.
Have you ever watched Love After Lockup, Bobby?
No.
Well, start.
You're in.
It's great.
Is it good?
It's better than good. It's so good.
I'm going to say something very old.
Yeah.
Sure.
What channel is it on?
WE TV.
Oh, it's on WE?
Women's Entertainment. But I'll tell you what, women are trash garbage, and this is the kind of trash garbage they want to watch. WE TV is the trashiest of all, well, the...
Worse than TLC.
I'll drop something on you right there.
Please.
I believe the person running that is the guy that was running True when I started that got ousted.
No way. Yeah.
Well, they kicked the genius out. Because I will say, this show...
This guy is making a hit.
He was like a dictator over there.
Really? Oh,
yeah.
This guy... This show is about people who get relationships when they're in prison with somebody out of prison, and they come out and, like, basically live with them, not knowing much about them. and you follow their stupid, stupid people lives. And it is great. But there is a couple who I've been showing Dan bits of. Christine, see if you can find the videos of them in the car together and stuff, Monique and Derek.
It is just, it's
a guy got out of jail. He's short, he's muscly, decent looking guy. And she, and I'm not exaggerating, it looks like Patrice's fatter sister. It's the gap teeth. She is morbidly obese. And when the best scene is them driving in a car together, because she has a seatbelt extender on too, so her seatbelt splits in three ways in the middle of her belly.
They got her locked in.
And she's like always NASCAR? And she's just like this, and like with her big like gap teeth. And he, this guy can build a fucking a pillow fort in how much room he has. He's like this thing stretched out, like he's laying down like this, and she just takes up. It looks like she's 4 feet in front of him.
Do you remember in Empire Strikes Back when Jabba the Hutt has that little guy?
Yes.
That's what it looks like.
Yes.
Like Jabba's the lady and the little guy is the guy.
Is he the guy smoking the hook?
Yeah, where he's like,
yeah, jumping around. That's, and he's like,
he had a name too. Is it something Scrim?
Yeah, Star Wars fans are mad that we don't know that.
Something Scrim? I don't remember. Christine, you got a big picture of them in the car together?
We got visual, we got optics on it. That's what we'd say.
Christine, we got eyes in this yet? Yeah. Because what I want to show you, because I know you love stuff like this. We've spent hours watching stuff like this. There's a couple called J&J Couple Reactions, and it's just a black couple who watch episodes, looks like Love With Your Lockup and probably other things. But the Love With Your Lockup one, they have one where this little guy is climbing on top of this lady, trying to like kiss her and like, you know, to beginning of having sex with her. And how hard... It's just a black couple laughing this together is so infectious and fun. It really made me laugh. Do you have a picture, Christine, at all? This seems like not a hard thing to be not having a picture up of yet.
I know. Well, you want the two of them in the car together, and I'm just going through all the YouTube clips trying to find that screenshot.
Reaction video sounds like a real sweet deal for a career.
It made me think. It made me think, like, did me and Christine ever leave the house? Like, just sitting there watching me watch a show has got to be kind of entertaining, if I told. Like this. Well, that's not even. They don't have the guy in this one, but you can still see it. You get it.
I didn't think. Well, I never heard of a seatbelt extender in a vehicle. I've seen it on a plane.
Right. They make them.
I'd love to hear that guy's math on the side of his differential, and he goes, "Now, she's a big girl. What percentage of that is titty?"
And that's the guy.
33%. Now, 33% of titty.
And that's the guy right there. The guy's little.
Oh, that's him.
Yeah. A little Derek.
Now he's in jail.
He was in jail.
And she started dating him while he was in jail.
Of course, because you can't leave when you're trapped in prison.
So these lonely women go and they fish out these studs that are dented or broken, and then the show follows them. And they always come out of jail in like storybook love, where they're like,
"Oh,
this person's going to solve all my problems. Right. Everything's perfect."
But when you're sitting in jail, you'll write to these ladies and be like, "Oh, I want to have so many kids," but you're just trying to keep... It's like a choose-your-own-adventure story.
I found all my letters from Denise Cantino when I was in juvie jail.
Oh, really?
Oh, dude, I got love letters from this girl.
But you were also sending her love. Like, you were deep in love because you had nowhere to go.
I sent letters back, but her letters, you know, were, you know, mail day when I would get my little cards.
Did you
letters.
Smell them like soldiers in the war?
Did she spray them with... She's from Brooklyn, dude.
I had a girl live next to my dad one time send me a letter with glitter in it and sprayed perfume, and I was like,
glitter should be illegal.
I liked her.
Yeah, glitter's a lot, because you're like, now I gotta clean this up.
Glitter should be illegal.
When I was little, I didn't mind it so much.
She was great. She got me through, she got me through some times.
What happened after lockup?
Little hearts on the eyes.
Did you guys have love after lockup?
No, we never had sex ever. She was, we were young. I was 13. She was,
pussy.
Huh?
Yeah, you're already locked up, dude.
That's the kids' version. It's love after juvie lockup. Yeah, it's like 13-year-old.
Love after scared straight.
Yeah, they have to deal with something worse than the outside, puberty.
There you go. There you go.
Oh, Jesus
I mean,
Christ.
Dude, that's wild.
Oh, shit, dude. You weren't kidding.
I didn't know they made that either.
He looks like he wears her as a Halloween suit.
Jesus Christ.
He goes, "Well, time to put my girlfriend's suit back on and go dance at Chuck E. Cheese."
It looks like, did you ever see the Stay Puffed Marshmallow Man suit where it's like the fan inside that you buy at Party City?
Yeah,
like
blows it up. Yeah, that's her, and he gets in and he's like, "Whoa!"
She definitely needs an internal cooling system. Correct.
Oh my God. God bless her. Damn, she can never ride him. She'll crush his hips.
No, so what's funny about this is there's a video of the first time he tries to like kind of like start making out with her and getting sexy with her, and this couple, just play the audio of it. It's so funny. I thought this would just make everybody laugh.
Monique wants me in her own world. It's me and her, nobody else. I want this to work.
He's trying to get a position.
He's trying to climb it. Oh, wow.
He got a video.
When she going back to Chicago.
What? He got, look how he kissed her. Oh, my God.
Cover her.
Punk, punk. Babe.
Cover her up, dude.
Babe, she got the big ass titties out, bro. They looking all uncomfortable. Look how he, babe, just go back one time and go 10 seconds back.
Is it? Is this like our show?
This is a great watch.
I'm in this thing.
He got to.
Go to it.
At the same time. You never know what happened when she's going back to Chicago.
He's doing
one-handed
push-ups. He's like trying to keep himself up.
He climbed that thing. He's falling off. He just fell off her like a mountain.
Yo, shout out to J&J couple reaction. That was goddamn, really made me. It just, it was like infectious. It was just making me. I was in my hotel room and it just came on and it started making me. I was trying to show a card and their thing, and I just put that one on, and man, it just started making me laugh.
Yeah.
Instead of just having so much fun.
Yeah.
She can only date guys with a really good core.
Oh. Yeah. She can't date another.
You're
fat
not wrong.
Guy.
I couldn't date.
You got to do Supermans on her. Those things you would do that relay on the ground.
Yeah, or you'd have to stand, and then it would have to be like it would have to. It's a scientific process.
Well, I'll tell you what. She came up on the season premiere, Lou. You know this. She comes. They so of course she doesn't live where he lives.
Mm.
So she was there for the season of the show for a couple weeks, and then she goes back to Chicago. He stays.
Oh,
wherever
I thought
he's
she
at.
Was like that movie Troll, where she was just a mountain that ended up being a troll.
She is Gaia.
It's a good movie.
But she goes. But it was great. Was this is where the show left off pretty much yesterday? She shows back up, and he's like, "Hey, I want to move past all that. I don't want to talk about it no more. I cheated. This ain't right. It ain't cool. I'm supposed to be good to you. I'm gonna change, and let me be better to you." And then she goes, "Well, I came down here to tell you I'm late on my period." It was like, and he, dude, his face, he's like, "Oh, man. Man." Like,
how'd it get?
She goes, "You ain't happy about it?" He goes, "Oh, man."
How'd it get all the way in there?
I mean, that's what I was thinking. He goes, "I thought I came in like you. Like where your belly button touches on your two bottom bellies."
Well, I came on the first level, you pussy. Well, I didn't even get to the third level.
I'm late on my exclamation point.
Yeah. Well, then you know I got on my mechanical bull and it must have went up in there.
Well, shit. I didn't know Luke Skywalker'd you and you the Death Star. I blew you up with one shot.
I'm late. It's like, oh, shit, oh, dude. Could you? No. Oh, man, I can't imagine. But I said, my friend Little Jay, his brother Steve, when he got out of jail, same thing. There was just he was fucking a bunch of people, mostly our friends, like people that we knew our age.
Oh, is this brother?
Brother.
Yeah.
And he would, but he was hooking up, but he had this one girl, I forget her name, but she, I mean, had a full mustache and baggy arms and just like, but they believe, they get upset. They go, "What? Like, you know what's going on. You're going to have to be this lady and just accept." It's almost like when a guy's a sugar daddy, and the girls are like, "He just wants to pay for stuff for me." It's like, you're just going to have to be that if you want to be like seen with this guy. It's an ugly truth.
Yeah.
But it really is. You're going to have to accept that money and stop chasing, or you're going to be constantly pissed.
Yeah.
"Why are you talking to other girls?" And the other thing goes, "Because look at you.
Yeah.
You have a full mustache. You're not even trying."
Fucking you is like fucking on an upside down canoe.
Yeah.
I keep falling off and hitting my head.
Yeah.
Exactly. Those girls have no separation between those letters they were getting from prison. That's the point I was making before.
Yeah.
To when they come out. There's no separation in their mind. They're like, "But you said that we was going to get a house with a picket fence."
That's when I was having a guy braid my hair.
Exactly. That's when I would give a man donuts so he wouldn't fuck me in my sleep.
Things are a little different here.
Yeah. But this is Cleveland, not that.
"So you don't want to make love to me all day? Well, I didn't meet you yet. You're huge."
I remember when she said that one time, she goes, "Are we going to make love to celebrate?" He goes, "Yeah, we can do that." That's a funny answer.
Do you think when he
can do that. Showing up.
When he met her for the first time, was it like a shadow, like Independence Day? Like it just fucking casted over him? When he was standing outside and she walked up and just a dark shadow.
Hey.
Like, "Oh, you look tinier in pictures."
We could do that.
Yeah, he goes, oh, yeah, we could do that. I bet we could do that. They really, it's
just
so
my
fun.
Lady Eclipse.
But they are, they're either so disproportionate looking to each other, the couples, or they're like good looking at everyone. It's like a problem.
Is it like,
is that what the hot ones are?
Like a clearance rack at Marshall's?
Yes.
Like these women are just finding these men. Mm-hmm. And
they compare.
Are they throwing it out to a bunch of them, or are they?
I'm sure they're throwing it out to a bunch of them, and one of them latches on. Also, these guys in jail, or the girls in jail, yeah, they're also talking to 11 other people. Also,
right? Yeah, because so I had more than one girl I was talking to.
Love after Baba.
I'm sorry, I wasn't in love with one girl at 13.
Well, one of the most embarrassing things ever in the world, yeah, is the when the guy gets knocked out because they both show up to pick up a girl from a halfway house. And the other guy who likes her too much was just like, she doesn't want to deal with you anymore, dude. He's like, you shouldn't get involved in this, but he does. He's like, you don't want to, he's like, she doesn't want to deal with you, dude. And the guy's like, get out of my face before I knock you the fuck out. And the guy goes, are you? And he puts his hands behind his back, and the other guy just knocks him clean unconscious.
Really?
And then he wakes up and cries in front of the girl. And then the girl sends him on his own. The girl sends him off on his own, and then has the guy who punched him come back to pick her. You know, she told him initially not to come.
Right.
He did come, punched the guy she was leaving with, and then she left later with the guy.
I'm actually angry.
No,
yeah.
Don't
yeah,
be the guys.
You can't trust these halfway house women.
But I don't understand these guys are like, oh, really? And they put their hands behind their back.
That's
to
crazy.
A criminal.
It's like, what are you doing? If the guy
is threatened. It's nuts.
Why would you do that?
Because I'll knock your puss ass out.
Oh.
And there he goes.
I mean, he goes right to jail for that, though.
Nope.
It's on camera.
Doesn't matter.
No.
Ooh, he could have hit his head right on the...
His arms are still behind his back.
He did hit his head on the ground. You'll see the blood on his head.
Dude, look at it.
You gotta get up.
He was unconscious enough to not even block his fall.
Dude, his toes are curling like he's getting fucked in nylons.
But then...
Look at his toes.
That's the best. So they wake him up.
Oh, damn, dude.
They wake him up.
How does he not go to jail?
Not only does he not go to jail, he gets in the car and leaves right next to the cops.
That's security.
That's a cop?
Is that security?
And that's the girl?
And so far, it feels like a nightmare.
Yeah, by the way,
I didn't want there to be any confrontation
busted.
Or anything like that. Then next thing you know, they're talking to each other, and one thing just escalated to another.
Dude, you gotta run him over. He's like, move him.
He does. He says, move him, yeah.
The kind of
he goes, move him out of the way.
That I had imagined for myself.
And then she had a diamond on her chest?
Oh, wait, she got total trash tattoos.
Keep him in play. I want to see him back up.
Hey, stop. Stop.
Y'all get him off the ground.
This guy's no fucking around.
Stop.
He's the best. Dude, they would catch him cheating constantly, and he just goes, why you get upset about all that? I came home afterwards. And they're like, you right.
Really?
Yeah, he's got it.
He didn't come home. He's a blonde girl that he has like a whole other relationship.
Yeah, he's got a whole relationship going, too. He's so mad about this, he's got a whole relationship.
You can cheat on Katie. You just come home.
Just go home, dude.
That'll definitely not get me killed.
Buddy,
just gotta go home.
Is that Dawn's rule?
That, well, listen, does she
is that
tell,
Dawn's rule?
She wants me not to come home.
Yeah.
Just, when you finish, fucking stay out there.
Yeah, go off with that fucking diamond tit chick.
Yeah, you got the tiny house. Go up there, you cocksucker.
Yeah.
You fucking live in your little house, in your little hole.
This guy, I don't know if it shows in this clip, but
does
when he wakes up, yeah, that's the best part.
Who double books a halfway house pickup?
He goes, egg on my face. I told Trey to get me.
Oopsie-doodles.
Sal, he loves the drama.
Yeah.
These guys fighting over her is the highlight of her
life. I love Sal's coming at it from a normal person.
Yeah.
Why would he hit him?
Yeah.
Why would he?
You double book a halfway house pickup?
Why wouldn't he wait till he gets out of the way to back up?
Was his anger caused by gas prices?
The way this gets, which I don't know if it's in this clip. Hopefully it will be, but I'll describe it either way. The guy, he wakes up finally, and he's kind of like, "Where is he? Where is he at?" And they're like, "He's gone."
Anybody see that train?
So he's gonna leave, and so he pulls up in a car. She just has her stuff on the curb.
It's been 5 years, like Endgame.
Yeah.
Like,
he's got a long beard.
Yeah. He has no idea. He goes, "What happened?"
No, Thanos snapped, and I was gone.
Joe Biden's the president. They show him. He pulls up next to her, and he's got the hat backwards. He's like, what's up? You ready to get out of here? And she's kind of like, yeah, I think I'm just going to wait for another ride and just relax. And he's like, yeah, you sure? Am I going to see you soon? And she's like, yeah, I'll call you. We'll figure something out. And he's like, yeah, that's fine. And then it cuts to him, and it seems like away doing like a confessional in the car with the camera. And he's just like, I just thought this time when she came out that it was going to be different and we'd be able to be with each other. And then they do a wide shot. He's just like, she's as close as DJ Lewis to me out to the car, like kind of rolling her eyes. And so he got beat up and he's crying and she's not going. Like, and all he is thinking this entire time is, why did I sign the release before I picked her up?
Yeah.
They could have blurred his face.
Yeah. Oh, fuck.
He could take that back. He could have. He probably doesn't know the rules.
Yeah, probably.
Can you really?
Just like Sal is like the lawyer of this episode.
Oh, well, yeah.
You can actually take that back.
Because legally, he could have been blurred out.
Do any of you, I feel empathy. I feel bad for that guy.
I want to see him wake up crying.
I don't feel bad for him. You know why?
The hands behind the back.
Listen, go ahead, hit me. He said, go ahead, hit me. Put his hands behind his back.
That's an 8-year-old's game to play. Yeah. You don't do it with a grown man. Go ahead, free shot. Because if someone...
I think if somebody did to me, I hate those tense knockouts. I hate those.
Yeah, of course.
I feel like there's damage being done internally.
100%.
This could have been the best fight Fat Joe's ever seen.
Don't think I'm not doing it with John Jones this weekend.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You home for it?
Yeah, I'm home. Yeah.
Oh, nice.
You around?
I am, but
I'm having people coming over. Okay. I didn't know. I thought you were gone.
Nah. Is that this weekend? Ball.
Yeah.
Who's he fighting?
Cyril Gane.
Oh, okay.
It's going to be a goodie.
Yeah. Good. You like it? You like it, Jacob?
I always enjoyed watching the fights, but I don't know too much. I don't know about these guys, but I'm looking forward to it.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Yeah.
What did you think of the Volkanovski? Did you see that one? The Volkanovski.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
What's his name? He went up at weight class.
Islam.
Yeah. Makhachev.
Yeah.
That was a great fight, man.
Who won it?
Islam won in a decision, but it was super close.
Jacob's got to walk out. He hates fight talking.
You do? Yeah.
Does not like violence. He's a pacifist.
Are you leaving?
What are you pissed off about, Jacob?
I didn't toot.
Did Bobby fart again?
I did not fart.
Did Bobby fart?
Did I fart?
Bobby,
I didn't fart.
What happened? Bobby, did you fart?
I did not fart.
Yeah, I believe you.
Okay, great.
No, that's what I'm saying.
I went like this. I swear to God, I didn't fart.
Did you go to Wag Your Fart by Christine and Jacob?
Crop Dustin? You making him pay?
What's happening? You didn't.
No, it's fine. What's up? Now we're curious. Now.
I mean, what's happening,
Jacob? You got a Buddy Holly vibe going on in him.
Yeah, I love it. Isn't it nice?
It's good. It's very good.
Sexy.
It's what's with these homies?
What's this? My girl. Why they got a front? I want to see him wake up from the knockout.
Oh yeah, it's great. Fire. Oh, he's crying.
And the car's gonna be different. His car's gone.
That guy's no joke.
I'm done with
this guy's driving away with a GoPro
so
in his car.
He's so tiny.
Yeah.
He's tiny, but look at his rounded shoulders.
That's definitely a shirt from Express.
Yeah.
Oh, the way he dresses just generally is pretty great, this guy. He's all about, I think he...
He dresses like a bullfighter.
Does he live with his mom, or his mom comes over every day and smokes butts? It's like that kind of shit.
If you were a guy built like that, would you wear the dress shirts where it's tight on the arms?
I don't think I would. Oh, I can't wait. I hope I lose more weight just so I can wear one of those.
You're going to look good.
I would do some real... At this point
it
now,
always looks
fashion
like
would
it's...
be a playground for me, dude.
I want to get the little wraps, the little garter belts for your biceps.
Oh, like old-timey?
Yeah, like a bartender back in the
ooh,
day.
Yeah, like a barbershop quartet.
Yeah, one of those guys. Yeah.
Maybe grow one of them stashes?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, 100%.
I'd love that.
Do some weird shit with facial hair.
Boston Tea Party, Bobby?
Yeah. I can't wait. I want to see him wake up from the punch.
I decided to just go on and take it back to the house and say both of them. Just forget about this, put it behind me.
Was he trying to quit? He hasn't lit that cigarette.
Oh, dude, he peeled out.
He hasn't lit that cigarette since the fight.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Got it? Come on, you can do this. Hand up.
Jesus.
Damn.
His tattoos are gayer now that he got knocked out.
Is he okay?
Like, of waves and suns.
It's so humiliating.
It's very confusing, you know, with everything going on and all the emotions I had. So sensory overload.
He looks like the guy who played the other Hobbit in Lord of the Rings, doesn't he?
Yeah, yeah. Not fucking... not Rudy, but the other guy.
Is it Dominic Monaghan?
Yeah,
I don't know how I pulled that out of my ass.
Wow.
I never even seen The Hobbit.
That was fucking
nuts.
Great.
That is who it is.
That's
that
nuts.
Was great.
Good for you, dude.
It cuts before the part you're talking about,
Jay. I want to see him weep.
That's the best. Well, right, he cries.
I do feel bad for him now, Sal.
Right,
thank you so much.
Cries.
Because I know your heart.
No, I do feel bad for him. And now that he was up, he kind of was like, oh, shit, I've been knocked out. I've woken up 4 hours later.
What?
Four hours? That's a coma.
Yeah, dude, you could have killed.
Dances with Wolves in that.
I got
What, did you dream the Irishman?
I hooked up with this girl, one of the hottest girls ever.
Ever.
And we spent the night by the ocean.
She was a strong man who knocked you out?
We spent the night by the ocean in Quincy, Massachusetts, making out on the roof of my car, watching clouds go by the moon. I drove her back to her grandmother's house where she lived.
Romantic.
And we were in the car, and we were kissing, and then high beams were behind me. And I went, hey, what the hell? And she goes, oh, no. I went, what? She goes, it's Louie. I go, who's Louie?
Louie, Louie, Louie. He goes, why are you making out with my girlfriend? That's fucked up.
And I guess we're through now.
I don't know. I was going to come on her, but now you're kissing her.
I got out of the car. You should never get out of the car.
No.
You should tell her to get out, deal with it.
Yes.
I just met you. I'm not in love with you. I'm in lust with you. I go, I'll take care of it. I got out of the car, and apparently he got out of his car
first.
And as I turned to go face him, he hit me. I went out.
No questions asked?
And no, it was in Boston. What are you going to do?
Yeah, they're not asking questions.
He's not going to slap me with white gloves. Yeah. I challenge you, sir.
You like the socks?
Yeah.
So
he's like, hey, I got the fucking high beams on him and they're locking lips. I'm going to knock him out.
And then he
you like apples?
Hey, fuck you.
And he kicked me in the face with his steel toe boots.
Oh, fuck this guy.
While I was out.
I hate this.
Steel toe boot. What was this guy wearing? Dracar, too? Probably.
I think it was Polo.
What did he pull up in an IROC Z?
It was a truck. He was a working man. He was a big.
He knocked you out, kicked you in the face.
I woke up in the hospital. She had to take my Hyundai Excel hatchback, which I just got. Never was the same after that because she didn't know how to drive a manual, so she just
grinded the clutch.
Yeah, all the
way. Burned your clutch out, too?
Burned my clutch out.
You live this!
And then I woke up in the hospital 4 hours later, and my face was, you couldn't even recognize me. My face was swollen. Couldn't recognize me. I had to get surgery under my eye. They had to take a bone out of my head to put under my eye so that my eyesight wouldn't be messed up. And then he broke my orbital bone. He broke my nose. My septum is still twisted from all that stuff. So that's why I have a tiny.
Damn, dude, you're like Mr. Glass. What it's a fragile crazy. Face.
They call me Mr. Glass.
But then the sad part of it is that we went back to her house and I had to go to her grandmother's room to sleep, which was just uncomfortable. Just smelled like old ghosts.
While your nose is just leaking.
I had to drive myself home the next day in my Hyundai Excel hatchback. And I went home and I had to go to the hospital.
Can I get my dick sucked for trouble?
Dude, it was bad. I couldn't
talk. Was she over you? I mean, was that it?
Or? Well, you know, it's so funny. She came over one other time after I healed. And this was when I was probably in the best shape of my life.
Hot Bobby.
I mean,
the whole time you were healing, you were training to fight this guy.
She came. When I live with the six mentally retarded guys.
Yeah, yeah.
And she came over and blew me. One time, like after while I was healing, and then I went to
who was on drool duty,
dude. Yeah,
I gotta do my drool rounds. Hurry up and suck me off.
How did he know where you? How did he know where you were?
This was after she came and blew me over there. After
the guy,
we were in front of her house. We were in front of her house, her grandmother's house.
Oh, I thought you were by the ocean.
That was her boyfriend.
Grandmother do for work
in Quincy. No, it was Quincy. It's not like the ocean. It's like a bog.
Was she still with him? Was she still with him when she blew you?
Well, here's the funny part. I went to this after I healed. I went to the sober nightclub. I used to go to sober nightclubs, and it was in Quincy. And I went back. And all of a sudden, she came down the stairs. I haven't talked to her in months. And she came down the stairs with my friend, Jamie Giorgio, who I knew when we first got sober, a little Jewish guy, now adopted by pretty much, you know, Italian guys from the North End, if you know what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
Adopted by Stephen Giorgio, worked for the Giorgio family at La Famiglia Giorgio's, satin La Famiglia jacket. He had one of the first cell phones that you had to carry, the briefcase thing on your shoulder.
Damn.
Holding her hand, walking down the thing.
This guy gets people to hit you.
He came down. He's like, Bobby, how you doing? And then
hope your face is healing up from that goombas who put you up before.
Yeah. She was like, hi. And she walked right by me. And she blew. But me and Jamie actually became really good friends after that. We are still friends to this day.
What happened to her?
That whore died.
She died?
No, I don't know. I have no idea. I hope she died.
What happened to Louie? What happened to her tough, hot boyfriend that fucking roughed you up?
You know what?
Me all bothered. What happened to the man of the story?
I
could swear there's a story of DeRosa getting beat up with a girl. I think DeRosa at the pizza place on the corner of Caroline's, he went in there with one of the girls. I remember it was Maggie and her friend. And her friend like hung out a bunch too. I don't know why I'm blanking on her friend's name.
Sure.
Do you remember them at all?
No. Sue. I remember Sue.
No.
Yeah, come on.
But whatever it was, DeRosa, I don't know if he was hanging out with her or hooking up with her or whatever, but they went to a pizza place.
And that like, pizza I'm place almost... that is now like a I Love New York shop.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I know exactly. Yeah.
He went in there and a lunatic came in and hit her. Like hit her. And then Joe didn't even get through like the, hey man, what are you doing? And just knocked, I think he knocked Joe down too. I think I brought up in front of Joe recently. He's like, I don't remember that. I'm like, why would I remember that if it's not, something happened with that. Yeah.
He goes, what are you doing? Ow, ow, ow. Yeah.
Well, that was great when DeRosa, one time was being funny outside the cellar with somebody. There was this tiny little Mexican guy, long, long hair, like down past his butt. Looked like, I mean, he was just tiny, but it was still like, you know, like a little...
Apocalypto?
Yes.
Yeah.
But he came over and he tried to say something on the phone. He's arguing on the phone with somebody, the payphone that used to be when it was functioning still.
Sure.
He's yelling on the payphone outside the cellar, and whatever it is, he's angry, and he hangs up and he goes, he like bangs the thing like three times, like, you know, and then throws it down the ground.
Is this the De Niro Goodfellas?
And then DeRosa just comes, whatever it was, he was like, all right, buddy, like, chillax, or whatever kind of, like, line he said, like, to make us all laugh to the guy. And the guy came back, and he's like, what, motherfucker? What? And he started walking back so fast, he was like, no, we have to get, like, between him, like, everyone relax.
I will never forget in middle school, we had this kid, this Mexican kid from Pueblo moved to our middle school named Jerry Garcia, and he was, like, straight cholo, dude. Like, fucking wife beater, slick back hair, muscles, and we were in, like, eighth grade, and he had, like, muscles, and my friend Byron, I think I told you this story. They go, Jerry Garcia. And my friend Byron goes, your name's Jerry Garcia? He starts laughing. Oh, turns out this kid was a Colorado Golden Gloves champion. No. And did like, it was the first time I heard anybody throw the punch with the noise. Oh. And he went, like that, and lit Byron up in his chair. Where Byron was like, you know, with the desk? You know how the desk is gonna, he was like in there, and he was like, ah! And I was like, three seats ahead. I was like, ah! I was like a bear got my friend. I was like, ah! He just goes, Jerry, your name's Jerry Garcia? And he was like, ah,
Dove David. Dove David.
Fucking wild.
Dove David did that to me one night.
Oh, yeah, because he boxes.
Me, Keith, Colin, and Dove after the cellar one night went to Crunch in Astor Place, and they had a gym upstairs with the 3-minute ding and the minute ding. You know, we went up there with no mouthpieces, and we started boxing each other with no headgear. And then Colin came up to me, was like ducking, but down. He was doing some weird. Old guy.
Too much.
Like 60s.
Going way down. And he was.
It's Queensberry rules, Bobby. Get your fucking.
And he did it the whole way across the ring, all the way over me. And then I just went, huh, and hooked him in the gut. And you heard, nah. And he went, huh. And then Dove came in. And I don't know what I was confident or something. And I just punched him in his face. And Dove went, turned to the side. And he went, ah, Bobby, you chipped my tooth. Just like 17 hits to my face.
Yeah.
That's all I heard. And I was like, eh, and I just kind of wobbled to the right diagonally and just leaned on the ropes. I was like, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to chip your tooth.
I'm so sorry.
Did you ever get to...
You heard Keith going, ha, yeah. Bob got lit up.
Don't beat the shit out of him.
Did you ever get to tough guy talk somebody because like you had full advantage of the situation? I had
once
my ex-girlfriend, Cheryl, when I was a teenager.
Shout out, Cheryl.
Her sure. sister,
not her dad though.
Her sister one time, they were like drunk. There were a bunch of drunk people over her house, like partying, and this kid who was in, we were seniors, and he was in the same, or maybe it was the year after high school or something, but it was, whatever it was, me and this kid were the same age, but he dated, I think Cheryl like before me a while back, but I didn't give a shit about that.
A former lover.
Yeah, I didn't give a shit about that, but it was like they were just drunk, and I don't know what their thing was with me, like. I don't know if her sister was shitty with me at the time or something, but she had him call me. This is house phones, too. And give me this whole rundown. He's like, yeah. He goes, your girlfriend used to suck my dick in the woods. Just like all this weird shit that was like.
In the woods is always more hurtful.
Well, it's always definitely true, too. Yeah. It means,
where you go, all right.
She was a woods blower.
Sorry, she's a woodland whore.
She's a woodland whore. It's a sluttier girl.
Yeah.
No, for sure. She definitely blew in the woods. Well, but she probably blew this guy in the woods. Whatever it was, he was just being. He was
there
goosed
was a time
up.
Everybody blew in the woods, honestly.
He got goosed up by the sister.
Before the Industrial Revolution.
Yeah.
Everyone's
before the printing press.
It was actually considered.
This wasn't a big guy. This wasn't a big guy at all. Like, he was nothing intimidating, but he was just wrapped up in the moment. He was impressing girls over there.
Yeah.
They were all drinking and stuff. And I'm just like, I didn't know where, I just know where he's hanging out. Like, the next day, me and Glenn, it's like me and Glenn, like two other of our friends went over there. And
shout
it was,
out, Glenn.
We saw him and his buddy outside and really got to,
Glenn rule.
It's so funny to hear it, to recite it back. In times, in the moment, I was always one of those things like, yo, we fucked that kid up, scared the shit out of him. But I must look so dumb, because it was really like, why would you say things like that? Because these are the repercussions when you let women tell you what to do. You're trying to impress girls, but now look at you. He peed his pants at one point, because Glenn had him the thing, and I was like, now, and his friend's like, oh man, it's, come on, he peed his pants. And I'm like, and we're like, shut up, you. It was like really, like a fucking movie. I go, guys, what have we learned from today's lesson? It was like such one of those. Yeah, like legitimately.
You picked his head up. You picked his head up by his hair, and you went.
I'm telling you, we gave one of them speeches. We gave him one of them speeches. He goes, next time I don't show up, you won't see me coming. Like that kind of shit.
You should have been like, at the end of it, you should have been like, now.
I just live with my folks.
Let's go to the woods.
Yeah, that's so fun.
You know what? I want to see if you got the skills still. Hey, why don't you make me go? That's why I do the.
Make him suck your dick, and then make him call her and be like, I sucked your boyfriend's dick.
Now pass it on.
That's why I want to do the Chris Hansen. Would you like to suck my cock in the woods, Pat?
I'm right here. The woods are out
there. Oh, I can't wait for you to suck my dick in the woods. Would you like for me to suck your dick in the woods,
Pat? That's so funny. Also, you getting busted. Remember how you got caught writing the girl the letter, and you just put the lyrics of Amanda from Boston into a letter, and then everyone knew it? What if you did that?
Everyone knew it.
But you did the walk-in speech from True Romance, and everyone knew it? Everyone goes, what? You're not even Italian.
He goes, and that's why you, Deanna Brady, are part eggplant.
Yeah.
Like, what?
She goes, all ready for that Chesterfield now. No one is saying the part. That'd be so funny. Hey, God and all the angels.
Hey, boss, I think about to be happy.
My step-pop loved Boston, the band.
Oh, yeah, I did too. I went to see him three times.
With the original guy?
Do you know the comeback?
Wow.
The comeback.
The original guy, though, huh?
Well, no, was he there? No, yeah, he was there. Yeah. It was back in the 90s.
Did no, I? Gone.
90s.
He was gone.
80s.
He was
70s.
Gone. 70s.
It was when
sure.
I was three.
But Boston, my step-pop loved him, and it was just I had written a letter, an ask-out note. For some reason, the note, I can do it. I was nervous once I gave it, but I can give the note and keep it moving, because sometimes they would just write back nothing, and you would just kind of like take that as the sign. But I wrote a note to everybody. I was out of things to say to every girl that was, I thought was like cute in school. It was all like a clique, basically. And the last one was Deanna Brady. And I just, my step-pop had Boston playing in the background. And it's just like, I'm going to take you by surprise and make you realize. Deanna?
Oh, my God.
Stole the entire song. I said it was a poem. I go, I wrote you this poem. Meanwhile, it's a poem. It's verse, chorus, bridge. A lot of I love yous in there. Let's get away forever. Like, it's like way too intense. But I gave it, I wasn't even thinking about that. My mind was like, I was like, oh, well, at least though, like these are, I knew that like, we're young. I only know Boston because my step-pop's in the Boston.
Sure.
That's not, never thought of the proposition of the issue being that they know that I've plagiarized the song.
Plagiarism in a love.
And then walking by them in the hallway, and they're all doing like, I'm gonna take you by surprise, make Deanna. And you're like, I don't, what?
What's crazy is I did almost the exact same thing in seventh grade, but I used the song LaGrange by ZZ Top. So when you read the note, it went, when you want to go right outside LaGrange. Yeah,
they got a lot of nice girls out there.
How. If you want to go to the dance, there'll be a lot of treats there. Yeah, I heard they got a punch bowl.
Yo, if you want to go to the dance in the gymnasium, the teachers are going to be drunk out there. Oh.
You stole this. I go, shut up, girls are gross.
Before we take our last break, can I just show you how popular the thing I said? Cause I don't think I've taken credit for this yet.
Yeah, but I want to like dive into, but you are.
Dive into what?
There's really nothing to dive into. You're right. It's just credit where credit's due.
Well, I deserve this because, as always, what happens, even with World Star Hip Hop in general, I feel. Mm-hmm. I was bringing up World Star Hip Hop when people were like, what the fuck's World Star Hip Hop? And now it's in the app, and now it's everywhere.
Yeah, Jay's ahead of the curve. Jay knows stuff before it hits the zeitgeist.
The other day I said something about Come Walk. Everyone goes, come, what does that even mean? I go,
down on the
Well, it's what you think it is. They go, what do you mean? I go, it's a girl with load on her face, and then she takes a nice public walk. And then I was like, what? And then I showed them videos of it, and I was like, I've never even heard of this before, ever. And now I go on World Star Hip Hop, which is the mainstream of thing, and it says, this the new trend or what, right? Yeah, this the new trend now, and it's just a girl doing a fucking cum walk.
And she's putting this on regular World Star, though?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Down on the cum walk. Cum walk.
Oh, when you'll have a face glistening with the semen of a man.
Down by the cum walk, out by the sea.
A paper towel for my baby's face is where I'll be. Look at her, dude. Look at her cum walking, Jacob.
I don't have my glasses on. I can't even.
Wow.
Well, that glistening stuff, cum.
I'd go like this. Oh, yeah. Excuse me, miss. You look glazed.
I don't know why you like this, but you didn't like it when Marilyn Manson did it.
Different, dude.
It's different.
Yeah, if Marilyn Manson had load on his face, I wouldn't have been so freaked out.
But does she have a job and a family?
Yeah, cum walking.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, she has a job, and she doesn't have enough money for a car, so she has to cum walk to and from work, so. Oh,
yeah. Damn.
And those glasses keep falling off.
How great
face.
Would it be in this
Are you going to judge her for cum walking to and from? She gets a reception.
By the way, 100% this is a Kohl's. And what's funny is, her in the Kohl's parking lot, someone just goes, is that Jeanette Ferguson? And she goes, oh my God, hi Amber, how are you? What are you doing? She goes,
well, I told you.
Walk.
I told you.
No,
awesome.
She just doesn't mention it.
She goes, yeah, no, I actually heard that Ashley got breast cancer, but it's in remission.
She goes, oh, do I? That is embarrassing.
Oh my God, there is cum all over my face. What a slut.
It's cum. I thought I washed this off when I sucked the guy off in the bathroom.
100% cold.
So she went to the bathroom. She blew a guy. He came.
I don't know how she coaxed it out. I don't want to throw aspersions.
All right. Yeah.
So she could have summoned it in many ways.
It's not like a cum second. Like, I'm just wondering if she got the cum in her face in public or was it?
Oh, right from tap.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, right from tap in the bathroom. She sucked the guy off, probably.
So that's the way you have to do it. Cum like, walks if I'm going to do this.
Right.
It's too infant in the cum walking stage to have an applicator that isn't a penis.
Okay. I'm just wondering, because if I'm going to do this with Dawn, I'd like...
You're going to send her with cum from home?
Yeah, I don't want to do this.
One of those bags with the little giant blue ice cube in it.
She goes, all right, Bobby, I'm in the fucking parking lot. Here you go. Turning the bag inside out.
I'll do it at Saks. I'm not doing it at Kohl's or Marshall's.
All right, I'm walking through, you fucking weirdo.
Yeah, he goes, I'm going to Nordstrom off rack.
Nordstrom.
This just showed up on the side.
What is that?
Did you see the thing of the guy who kept getting banged into by the lady's cart at Costco, and he picks up a Costco cart and drills her with it?
That's impressive strength.
Go to a Christina, we'll take a break. I know the show's almost over.
That is impressive strength to pick up a fucking shopping cart and throw it at someone.
Hey, man, throw a shopping cart, lady.
Yeah, the balance is the wheel.
This is crazy.
It's the weight distribution.
This lady, it's awful. What's great about this kind of video, this lady is living her life under the idea that he's not throwing it at me. He's probably pissed and he's going to throw it at my cart or something. A direct shot.
Does she look like she has a husband that went, finally, someone fucking did something?
I don't. Well, they show the whole thing. Is like,
where is this?
They're in line at Costco.
At Costco? All right. Well, at least she just came from getting everyday low prices.
So he keeps hitting her, so he walks over there.
Unconscious.
Oh, for sure.
No.
Oh, that's crazy.
They blurred it. Go to another one. There's one that shows the whole thing, and it is fantastic.
God. My God, dude. That is a tables, ladders, chairs match. This is extreme rules.
That's not even scored.
Yeah.
Look at this. Gag!
Oh, my God. I cannot watch this.
Well, that's why you shouldn't be on your phone like that.
See, if that was my mother, my wife, my sister, I would want to kill somebody. I would want to kill that man.
But if it was your wife, wouldn't you be like, wouldn't you for a second be like, I told you not to get on your phone?
Yeah, why are you fucking knocking into the guy?
Yeah.
Damn, Bionic Man. You're fucking... Yeah.
I would kill that man.
Pay attention to what you're doing. You don't get hit by
How does someone not walk over to him and just knock him the fuck out?
The, I know the other guy walks in and goes, oh, no, my 7 loaves of bread from Costco. That's great. I know we got to take a break. I know we have to. We're hanging out with Sal Vulcano. Bobby Kelly's hanging out with us all day today. It's the Bonfire. No reads on a Monday. Oh, I'm so close to my Duke.
Are you? Oh, yeah. I already took one. Mine's a past member.
Oh, listen to these words.
Damn, look at that. Those, that tight stick didn't do a goddamn thing. This way. It's grease from Margaritaville.
Like you had a cum walk earlier.
I know, I did a cum walk. Sal goes, looks like you had a cum walk earlier with my shirt.
It may be too soon, I know. Oh, what an eighth grade ballad.
Yeah, this is dance. This is at the dance for sure. Like this.
Oh.
Did you do waist or did you do two
No,
shoulders?
So me, I was waist, she was shoulders, Janessa Farigelli, and she was overcomplicating it. She was doing a 1-2-1-1-1-2-1, which I was having a hard time with. So I was so nervous. And not only was she doing that, was this on my one shoulder and friends. I was mint condition, pretty brown eyes.
Pretty brown eyes, you know.
Bonfire, be right back.
Thanks for Robert Kelly and Sal Vulcano coming by. Sal on tour at Impractical.